morning, students. Okay, so today I'm taking the social science in that sources of medieval period. It is a chapter history number 1. So in the primary source, I already in the previous class I explaining about the inscription monuments. Next is coin. In the coin, I said you it is portrait the picture and it is convey the portrait the picture and convey the names of the kings and the titles and events and places and dates, dynasties and royal emblem in that. So what is the composition of this metal coins means they says about they giving the information in the pre in the அந்த காலத்தோட information அது என்ன மாதிரி இருக்கும் என்ன மாதிரி coin அந்த coinல வந்து என்ன மாதிரி information இருக்கு அதுபடி பாத்தீங்கன்னா it is the information based on the economic condition of the empire side and the mention the king achievements ராஜாவோட என்ன தோல்விகள் என்ன வெற்றிகள் எல்லாமே அவங்க சொல்லிருக்காங்க இது பத்தி like a military and military conquest and territorial expansion and the trade links and the religious faith can also can found in the coins so in the coins la vandu pathina in the coin I said you the portrait the picture and other things in the coin related who related the related one person name is Mohammad Gauri Mohammad Gauri is a person who stamped this figure and the goddess. What is the stamp the figure? Stamp figure. What is the stamp figure means? Goddess Lakshmi. Nama male male na yaar male vandu male god kena solra god mattum solrom female god to goddess Lakshmi was stamped by the Mohammad Gauri and he is the and in the gold coin it is in the gold coin he has mentioning gold coin in the gold coin he is explaining about that and in that this coins tell us that early Turkish invader in the Mohammad Gauri la vandu avanga enna a stamp figure pannirukanga in the stamp figure means what is that the goddess of the Lakshmi and should be in the gold coin and giving that and it explaining about the goddess of Lakshmi the goddess Lakshmi and after that who is this invader yaar vandu idu invite pannirukanga na turkish who means turkish invader so they are invited this one and was all likely liberal of freedom in the religious outlook in that freedom we have Mohammad Gauri has give the freedom because he is a Turkish invader he gave the freedom for the religious outlook so copper jitals means are available for the study of period copper jitals here copper jitals means here they says about the it study what you study the period study the period what is the period of means Delhi Sultan period he studies Lakshmi coin of Gauri here this is a Lakshmi coin we have in the Gauri period this is a coin of Khalji this is a coin of Khalji this is the goddess Lakshmi coin which made in the gold coin and after that silver tanka here silver tanka introduced by Iltutmish idu yaar introduce silver coin vande yaar introduce pannirukanga na Iltutmish has introduced silver coin has introduced by Iltutmish has introduced the silver tanka so in the and gold coin Khalji gold coin has introduced by Mohammad bin Tughlaq gold coin ipo vandu silver coin yaar introduce pannirukanga Iltutmish gold coin yaar introduce pannirukanga here gold coin introduced who introduced means here they says about the Mohammad bin Tughlaq Mohammad bin Tughlaq has introduced the gold coin. So both of them, the Iltutmish has introduced the silver tanka and the gold coin has introduced by the Mohammad bin Tughlaq. So in that, they are the token. It is a copper token currency which indicates. initiative or coinage as well as the economic prosperity of otherwise of the country of that time. Of that time, and the gold coin, what the purpose they are using means their purpose used for the economic development. Jital means what? Jital is containing the 3.6 grains of silver. It is a 3.6 grains of the silver. 48 jitals are equal to silver. Silver tanka vandi, it is a 48 jitals compare pannum bodhu one silver jinka equal a irukum solittu solranga, okay va? Because 48 jitals like copper coin adula vandi enna, it is a 48 jitals vandi one silver coin ku equal a irukku solittu solranga. So it is a talks about the coin. So next is religious literature. What is the religious literature means? They talks about the devotional movement. They appome vandu pathina religious literature nammoda literature eppadi nama follow pannum poru like that religious literature. In the religious literature, devotional movement in South India, we have, and later in North, resulted in development of the bhakti or devotional literature. Ipo vandu nama God mele romba bhakti irukum. So adu vandu nama eppadi idu pandrom, temple pona they are singing a song for the sake of the God, and we are praying in the mosque, and church they are singing for the sake in the church, giving the speech for the gods. Okay, these are the things which happened in that. The Chola period was known as the period of devotional literature. Chola period, Chola period is called a devotional literature, and also the works such as like a Ramayanam and Periya Puranam. So, this is Periya Puranam, and I said you Nalaya Divya Prabhandam, which composed by the Tubal Alvars. Yetana Peri? Tubal Alvars has composed in that. So complete by the Nadamuni and Devaram, composed by the Appar Sambandar and it is Sundarar, and complete by that, all these things come under the Thiruvasagam, and all were inscripted during the Chola times. So Jai Devas, Gita, Govindam in the 12th century they are composed. So which have the follow up with the Bhakti movement is all this year. This all should be in the Bhakti movement, should come under that. So in the South India. So Kabir Das in the 15th century as a mystic poet also had an influence of the Bhakti movement. Kabir Das, Sur Das, yungella eppadi vandirukanga 15th century le vandirukanga. Okay, secular literature means, ipo vandu next nama paaka porradhu secular literature. Secular literature, second one is religious literature, second one is secular literature. Secular literature Madhura, Vyam and Mukta Tamalayadha. So it is a poem which composed by the Ganga Devi and Krishna Devaraya, which respectfully that help us to gain insight the events and individual associated with the Vijayanagara Empire. It is one secular period. It is a Chola period, let's start panirukanga, and this one is Vijayanagara Empire. Vijayanagara Empire, they should be started. And in that period, Chanda, Bardai, Prithviraj, Rasu, which portrayed, which saying about the Rajput king's failure. So, for the pre-Islamic period, Raja king pati, Chan, Bardai, Prithviraj. So, for pre-Islamic period, the only exception of the Kalhana Raj Tarangini, it is in the 11th century, they are saying, books, biographies and autobiographies. Minhaj-us-Siraj. So, it is a patronized life by the Sultan of Naziruddin Muhammad of Slave Dynasty. Tabakat-e-Nasiri. It is one of the book he wrote. Who means நசீருத்தீன் உமர். அதை வந்து என்ன சொல்லிருக்காங்கன்னா, த கம்பேனியன் விச் டீல்ஸ் வித் த பீரியட் ஃப்ரம் த கான்கஸ்ட் ஆஃப் த முஹம்மத் கௌரி. முஹம்மத் கௌரி எதுல பீரியட்ல இருக்காங்களா, ஏடில இருந்தாங்க. சோ அதுல வந்து ஃப்ரம் த கான்கஸ்ட் ஆஃப் முஹம்மத் கௌரி ஏடி எதுல வரும், அண்டர் த காமன் ஏரால வரும், 1260 இயர்ஸ். த கம்பேனியன் வாஸ் நேம் ஆஃப்டர் ஹிஸ் பேட்ரோன், ஹூ மீன்ஸ் இந்த 13th செஞ்சுரியில பாத்தீங்கன்னா ஹசன் நிசாமி. ஹசன் நிசாமி வந்து என்ன சேஞ்ச் ஆயிருக்காங்கன்னா, தே சேஞ்ச் ஃப்ரம் த கௌரி விச் ரோட் த தாஜுல் மசீர். தாஜுல் மசீர் டுவர்ட்ஸ் எண்ட் ஆஃப் த இல்துத்மிஷ் ரூல். ஓகே, இட் ப்ரொவைட் த இன்ஃபர்மேஷன். இது வந்து என்ன இன்ஃபர்மேஷன் கொடுக்குறாங்கன்னா, Qutbuddin Aibak, it is one of the person who living in the period and considered first official history of the Delhi Sultan. So idhila vandha enna solirukana, the Qutbuddin Aibak, it is one of the person who gave the official record in the history of the Delhi Sultanate. And Ziauddin Barani, which have the Muhammad Tughlaq wrote one of the book, that is a Tariq-e-Firoz, which Tariq-e-Firozshahi, in which he dealt with the history of the Delhi Sultanate. So Ghiyasuddin Balban, yaar paathina in the early years of the reign with the Firozshah Tughlaq as a farishta, Tariq-e-Firozshah our book le eldirukanga, yaar paathina Firozshah Tughlaq pathi in the 16th century le eldirukanga. So idhila vandha enna solirukanga, it all deals with the history of the rise to develop the Mughal Empire of the India. Okay, idu vandi enna na, all the Muslim names which shows about in that period, we have the biography and autobiography. Okay, students, thank you, see you in the next class.